The man accused of strapping a fake bomb to the neck of schoolgirl Madeleine Pulver is on his way back to Sydney from the United States.
Joining us from aboard the same flight as Paul Douglas Peters is 10's US correspondent Daniel Sutton. Dan, is there much security surrounding Peters?
Well, not as much as you might think. Mr. Peters is probably used to flying up the front of the aircraft. He's in the very back row aboard this flight. He was brought on board before other passengers by the US Marshals Service. He's currently being guarded by two New South Wales police detectives. They're sitting next to him. He's got the window seat. He's not been cuffed, and that's under an agreement that's been reached with the pilot. In fact, really, he's been more interested in just enjoying the flight and looking out the window than paying attention to the obvious interest that's being paid to him. It's a 14-hour flight, so the best thing he can really do is sit back. Thanks.
On the tarmac in Los Angeles, a breath of fresh air and some daylight. But Paul Douglas Peters' final destination on this 36-hour journey is a jail cell in Sydney. Sharply dressed but handcuffed, he arrived in LA aboard a commercial flight, guarded by US Marshals, accompanied by two New South Wales detectives. Does he want to go home?
My understanding, he does want to get back to Australia and face what he's got to face back there, yes.
In the early morning darkness, Peters was driven from Kentucky's Oldham County Jail, where he spent the past month and a half. Two flights later, he touched down at LAX, 8 hours in a holding cell before the monster 14-hour flight home. In Sydney, he'll be charged over the fake collar bomb attack on Maddie Pulver, where police allege he chained a hoax explosive device to the teenager's throat in a bid to extort money from her wealthy family. Charges which carry up to 20 years in jail.
Mr. Peters is a very intelligent man. He has a full understanding, I believe, of what serious matters he's going to have to be addressing when he gets back home.
He'll arrive tomorrow at 6:30 a.m. and is expected to face court over the weekend. Lawyers in Sydney are already working on his case. Aboard Qantas Flight 12, Daniel Sutton, 10 News.